Welcome back, everybody. It's the deciding game of our first best out of three for the series. Afir wins it in this 1v1 Shadowfiend mid. Well, he's going to win this whole event if S4 wins and then we go to the second best out of three. This one is not going to use those original rules we had where it's the first kill wins and there's no items. The reason for that rule was that you couldn't actually spend gold on heroes created via cheats. But now they can both pick Shadowfiend. So as a result, it's going to be a normal match using the normal rules. Two kills or two towers wins it. Now, generally in Shadowfiend 1v1 mid, if you get a kill, it's pretty much over. But there is always that slight chance for comeback with some amazing raises. Very, very slight at that. Fear versus S4. Lumi, who's your money on?
I don't know, man. S4 was throwing pretty hard on that second death Queen of Pain. It looked really bad. I'm not sure what he was expecting. A single Dream Coil and a Waning Rift would have killed him under tower, and he fell for that, so... With that said, though, I think S4 is better mechanic player. He's get better last hit. He seems like he's rune controlling better, as well as knowing what to do with those runes. Other than diving tower with the haste, I mean, like, he's using illusion runes to check. Like, he gets all the cutesy plays down. So it's harder. It's like old man Fierce got the experience. Like, he know what's happening, and the new kid on the block, he gets all the new tricks down too. So it's actually really hard to say.
Yeah, one thing that really interests me is what is the build going to be for each of these players? It's an early null talisman for S4, a little bit light on regen. You often see the bottle rush, and it looks like Fear wants to get his out quicker, going for more stats, more regen. So if he can harass S4 back early, S4 can get really zoned out of the lane. At the same time, S4 has that last hitting advantage, and we'll have to see if it makes a difference.
Yeah, this first block is going to be absolutely vital, because seeing the lack of regen on S4, Fear might actually want to take it very, very early, kind of 1v1 hit, kind of hitting war.
Yeah, and get aggressive.
And S4 has a heal against him, or with him, and he has the no talisman, so he Wraith Man. He should, if he blocks well, he should have this game. And I don't want to say that the game, you know, goes down on blocking.
He should have an advantage, for sure.
That big advantage could kind of snowball, especially when you're playing Shadowfiend. That first wave is so, so important.
Yeah, and notice Fear is using the Courier to scout. He chooses one to scout it very strategically. When he's up against Queen of Pain, he doesn't go for it. But when he's up against something like Puck, where you expect Phase Shift at level 1, he's a little more confident. In this case, Shadowfiend versus Shadowfiend, he'll scout with it, but he won't actually move the Courier towards the rune until the creeps have spawned and are on their way towards mid. I think he actually waits until he sees the enemy hero, then he goes. The rune is actually bottom. It's a haste. So he'll have the edge getting to that rune. S4 with a good block so far.
Yeah, Shadowfiend a little bit slow on that block. It's not really a block, he's just sitting here walking alongside next to his creep. So I do believe S4 is going to have that hill advantage. And when you have the Wraith Man and the hill advantage and the first creep, being the range creep to tank all the damage. Yep, S4, perfect block, I gotta say, but missing the last hits.
Yeah, he's got that extra 3 damage, but the big thing is going to be that high ground advantage. Actually, Fear immediately can start catching up. This is one of those ones where it's just like back and forth. S4, just not getting any of these last hits. There you go.
Yeah, I'm not gonna say that lag has anything to do with the.
It is a USC thing, but... server. Fear is a US West, so a slight pain in the ass for Fear, I believe, but pretty slight.
Yeah, it's very, very slight. So let it be said that none of the game is decided by, you know, server and whatnot. But right now it's 2-2, 2-2 in the favor, 3-2 now of S4. That Wraith Man, paying dividends, and the true difficulty is, can he get these last hits under the tower? And so far, it's looking pretty good using raises for these last hits.
Yeah, like you said, normally what you do to try and punish this is just get a little aggressive and trade hits. The problem is S4 also had the better block, so it's hard to do that. And now he's at a 6-2 advantage, and Shadowfiend is such a snowball hero. With this kind of a start, it's really hard to catch up. Each last hit coming easier and easier. He's 17 damage ahead already, and just Fear is almost doesn't have a chance anymore. He's just got to use raises to farm, and that's not something you want to do.
At this point, Fear basically has to wait till level 5 and win a kind of a critical raise engagement. But till then, he's going to be slower in terms of the bottle. He's going to be slower in terms of getting his boots.
And bottle's that's going to be crucial.
Bottle's already up, but slower in terms of getting all the other items. So it's going to be crucial advantage for S4 for the remainder of, you know, to level 5, I guess.
Fear's being a little more free with those raises because he knows S4 is the advantage. He's got to get his bottle out.
Ooh, look at S4's build. He's going Necromastery at level 3. He knows he's not going to be raising a lot. He knows he has the last hit advantage. He just want to get as much damage as possible and get that lead going. Very, very interesting.
Yeah, leveling up Necromastery 1v1 is pretty good. The one thing that interests me is, will either player go for the Korok build? What Korok did was... It wasn't 1v1 Shadow Fiend. It was Shadow Fiend versus another hero. But he said he prefers a single point presence of the Dark Lord because you get so much minus armor that it actually makes your physical damage a bit more efficient at the early levels. So we'll see if either player goes for it, but it's a little bit unorthodox, to say the least.
Yeah, I think most Shadow Fiend is very dependent on the raises, so if I see something like that, it'll be very, very interesting
Fear's
to talk about. But for
here.
Now, yeah, Fear's out of mana at this point here. He's using those raises very liberally. Salve gets canceled. The bottle is going to be coming in just a bit, and S4 knows he could actually zone the hell out of Fear, and that's exactly what he's doing right now. Look at his position right now. Fear can't even go into last hit because full mana on S4. He could actually go for the kill right now. Nope. Just, again, zoning him out. No CS, no EXP, or a slight amount of EXP for Fear. As these creeps gonna get denied, S4 just really, really hammering this one.
Remember that Fear knows where the rune is, and S4 does not because he didn't use his courier to scout. So he could go use his bottle, get the haste rune, but even then, it's gonna be hard to take a man fight versus S4 now that he's got level 2 raise and 2 points of necromastery, and he's ahead by, what is that, 25 damage. That is actually, not even that, 28 damage because he's got more base as well with the completed raid ban. He is so far ahead in last hitting. 33 CS to 10. But it is a snowball matchup. If you just get those first few last hits, the last one, you almost always just continue to pull ahead.
Yep, look at that. 3 rays being used just for a single creep wave. Very, very expensive. Looks like he's going to pressure Fear a lot, punish him for moving away from that tower. But here comes a haste rune on Fear, and he has level 2 rays. This could be very bad for S4. This could be where the first blood is. Raise 1, raise 2. S4's out of raises here. They have to fight the creeps doing damage, and S4 draws first blood despite the rune. Wow. And there's a regen rune on the bot. GG gets called. Is this just troll GG?
Yeah,
no, Fear's we're gonna go to round number 2.
It's standard rules, but I think Fear is just forfeiting. And that's the one thing about 1v1 Shadow Fiend is you can have the 2 kills or 2 towers rule, but realistically, if you give up a first blood and you're this far, I mean, certainly if you're this far behind, you're not
down by like 18 creep kills.
Yeah, that's four. That it's just those tiny little advantages, the slightly better creep block, going for the early wraith ban, having the hill advantage. It's so hard to come back, and it shows you how all those little things can really make a difference, even if you're on the identical hero. S4 takes the series, but it's not over yet for Old Man Fear. We're gonna come back to Shadow Fiend versus Viper mid, and then if we need a deciding game 3 in that series, it will be Shadow Fiend versus Shadow Fiend. Stay tuned.